Is crossing your legs bad for your back and can it cause your body harm? Well, today I'm going to give you the facts on this, and you're not going to want to miss this video because if you do cross your legs a lot, it may be an indication of a much bigger problem. Okay, let's start with the research on the subject first. This study shows there is a risk to blood circulation in the lower extremities as a result of crossing your legs. And common sense tells us that optimal circulation is a vital part for health. Okay, this is how your tissues get nourishment and oxygenation and how they remove the toxins. And as a result, this study shows there's much more discomfort in the lower extremities, such as the person's thighs and knees and the legs, as opposed to those who cross their legs, as opposed to those who sit in a normal chair all day long in a neutral posture. And for those of you who haven't read my book, a neutral posture is when the knees are bent to a 90 to 110 degrees between trunk and thigh. They also found that crossing your legs increases blood pressure in the lower veins because the knees flex in a fixed angle all day long. So crossing your legs additionally has reactive poor postures in the back, increased back flexion, aka hunching your back forward, increased pressure in the buttocks, or as they say here, bum. Did you know bum is a technical term? I love these technical terms. You ever get like a medical report and you get all these, there's like all these wonderful ways of explaining back pain, like herniated disc, bulging disc, disc protrusion, wear and tear. I got that one recently. I don't even know what the hell that means. Anterior lumbar interbody fusion, posterior lumbar interbody fusion. And if we want to translate all that into plain English, it means pain in the arse. Okay, I'm digressing, okay? Okay, I'll get back to the video. Did you know that crossing your legs can actually increase your ergonomic risk to your upper back as well? Mm-hmm, this is true. And there's a lot of evidence to support this because research found when people sit with their legs crossed for more than 3 hours a day, which is a lot of people, it increases your musculoskeletal risk in such areas as your neck and shoulders. And I think this is primarily when you cross your legs, you're translating your head forward. But get this, in the same study, researchers found that 80 to 90% of low back pain is a result of asymmetric sitting, aka knees crossed. Even give you a risk of spinal disease due to unequal use of supportive muscles, pelvic floor muscles. So put simply, you really need to find a way to abolish this habit and avoid long-term harm to your spine and potentially other areas of your body. And you don't want to get spondylitic myelopathy or whatever, you know, pain in the arse. So getting your ergonomics right is vital in this situation. But most up-to-date sitting research, such as my book, recommends that you should be slightly reclined, again, between 90 and 110 degrees. These are your neutral positions to limit long-term wear and tear on your spine. And if your chair doesn't have this, take a look at our foundation. Our foundation makes any seat ergonomic. The foundation positions your body in the optimal 110 degrees, roughly between trunk and thigh. And not only feels great, but it really you really can't cross your legs when you use the seat orthotic. Specifically, I've noticed if a chair seat isn't poorly adjusted, there tends to be a correlation with leg crossing behaviors, and some people just want to look cool, like this guy right here. The most up-to-date research, such as my book, recommends that back should always be slightly reclined, again, between 90 and 110 degrees, to limit long-term wear and tear, to use that diagnosis. So while good equipment is a major part of the solution, the user's habits and behavior should be absolutely equally addressed. And simply remember to sit in an optimal position may prove to be a far more difficult for a lot of people, especially if you've been crossing your legs for a long time. And for those people, I suggest using our foundation, or if you're going to change your seat to this angle, at a graduated schedule. Try to do it slowly, ease yourself into this from crossing your legs. Start with no more than 2 hours a day, and it'll take some time, but then you're going to feel like you're working out, and then your core muscles start strengthening up and your posture slowly improves, and you'll be transferring the load from your spine back onto your foundation muscles, and you're just going to feel great. I hope this helps. Please leave your comments below. Take care.